Hey, toy collectible fans, this is Fly Guy. We're looking at another in the Ant-Man Marvel Legends wave. We've already reviewed the Ant-Man himself, and this is Marvel's Wasp. This is the Build-A-Figure Ultron wave. There's the packaging there with that nice shiny Ant-Man logo. Great movie if you haven't had a chance to see it. Little Ant-Man logo up at the top as well. Real fun movie. Definitely recommend you go and see it. And Wasp may or may not make an appearance in the movie. You'll have to go and see it to find out. So this again is a Build-A-Figure Ultron part. There's all the figures in the wave and which parts come in them. So there for Marvel's Wasp number 2 is that's the torso she comes with. So we'll review Ultron rather than just show you a leg and an arm. We'll review Ultron as a separate piece at the end. All of these will be reviewed on our channel. So stay tuned, look for the Marvel Legends huge playlist and subscribe and you'll get all of these straight into your inbox. So this is the back of the pack and a nice image over there. It's a good figure. This is certainly a nicely designed figure. Janet Von Dyne or Van Dyne. A little bit of yada yada in different languages. And that is the packaging. Nice little similar to all the figures. Little ant drawing on the side of the package, which looks pretty good. Now the figure is a female torso, but it's a very good one and it just looks great. The facial sculpt they've done on here is fantastic. It's beautifully done job of the hair. I love the way they've done that. The black paint first of all and then that brown on top of it just looks fantastic. It's an excellent facial sculpt and a really good head on this figure, one of which will be right for customizers. I'll show you a very simple custom towards the end of this video, but some very good design done on that head overall. So you'll see the wings there on the back, again beautifully done. I don't recall a figure having these translucent wings before. I might be wrong. Please do leave a comment below if you know in the Marvel Legends line. It's the first time I've seen that for sure, but articulated wings, so they do look pretty damn good. So I may have put them in the wrong pegs, but no I haven't. Yeah, there's only one set of pegs, but they are articulated. So you can, if I move these out, if you wanted to, have them like so, or flat. It's entirely up to you. They come out pretty easily, so they're pretty straightforward. Solid pieces here. They're not kind of like Lego's thin plastic. These are pretty thick, pretty solid, very veiny and kind of ribbed. God, this sounds like a condom advert. But there we go. Pretty good. A little bit of Janet's bum showing there. A very nice little bottom that is. So the front of the figure, again, let's get a look at the rest of it. She's got a really nice gold paint on the breasticles and down in the abdomen, which looks very nice indeed. And on the hands too. So there's a nice applique to paint. As usual with Marvel Legends, very minimal. There's not a great deal of paint going on, but what that is just enough. Her head appears to be just a little bit big, too big for the body in my mind, but it's not out of proportion. And that's really it. I mean, it's a solid black plastic figure and a little bit of gold down at the bottom on the shoes. So really very simple, no texturing, no weathering, no dry brushing, nothing, not a bean. Bit of a shame, but that's what we get. So in terms of articulation, she's got a pretty flexible head there. You can see it will go back a fair bit, which allows you to kind of have her flying like that if you wanted to, and all the way forward as well. So right down, that's a really good head crunch on that. So plenty of movement on that ball joint of that head. As you can see there, you can see the peg. Same for the arms, you can see the ball joint there on that. So there's pretty much any movement you would want to. It's not really restricted or hindered in any way. Plenty of movement overall. We get a single joint at the elbows. Still, it's pretty good. It's a complete L. And you'll get that double joint on the swivel wrists and also that back and forth movement as well. So there's a complete flexible hand on each of her hands. So plenty of movement, which is good. That's what we want. The upper torso again is pretty flexible, but not a lot of room going on there. It's pretty much that far back and that far forward. So literally about an inch is all you're going to get out of that. We can get these little pegs up at the top there, and that allows them to swivel, and also the thighs swivel as well. You can see them moving there. And double joints at the knees, which is very much needed on a figure like this. and rocking articulated ankles, so plenty of movement in her. She gets some great poses. It's a really good looking figure in that way, and it's one of the it's the second best, I think, in the line overall. Quick little custom. If you pop the head off that and get the Toys R Us pack, which I never get a chance to review, this is the Maria Hill, basically using the Black Widow body. A very simple, not even a Dremel required. Pop off Maria Hill and pop on Janet Von Dyne, and you've got another S.H.I.E.L.D. agent. So I will be picking up another Maria Hill at one point and doing that, because I just love that more than I love Wasp. More S.H.I.E.L.D. agents, please. So that's looking particularly cool. So very simple custom. But love to know your thoughts on these figures, on the movie, Marvel's Ant-Man. What did you think? Did you enjoy it? Have you yet to see it? What do you think of Wasp? What do you think of this figure overall? I mean, these wings, I should have mentioned the articulation on them, but we showed that at the front, at the beginning of the video, the front of the video. Let me just show you there again. If I didn't, they are articulated. So again, plenty of movement there, and they can move independently of each other. So we're pretty, I mean, it's a rocking figure. It's not one that's bad at all. It's packed two per case, so you get a very good chance of getting this figure. So it's definitely one that I think you should try and pick up if you want the Ant-Man wave. The rest of them, not so much. It's definitely one for the Builder figure, but even that is slightly questionable. But we'll worry about that once we get to the Builder figure review. Again, love to know your thoughts on Wasp and Ant-Man in particular. Please do leave a comment below. If you're brand new to the channel, as you know, I'm sure, click subscribe. You'll get all this stuff straight into your inbox, all that stuff. And there we go. One more look at Janet's butt. All right, adios. We'll see you for the next review.